गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, वी आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू थिंक आईएएस चैनल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द एंथ्रोपोलॉजी क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स। अवर क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट आर पॉलीगैनी एंड पॉलीएंड्री एंड व्हाट आर देयर प्रिंसिपल कोरिलेट्स। पॉलीगैनी अकर्स व्हेन अ हस्बैंड हैज मोर देन वन वाइफ। इट इज यूजुअली फाउंड इन हर्डिंग, एग्रीकल्चरल एंड हॉर्टिकल्चरल सोसाइटीज। Cases in which having many children is particularly valuable, but also occurs in some foraging societies. Polyandry is much rarer and occurs when a wife has more than one husband. It tends to happen where living conditions are particularly harsh or where men must be away from home for long periods of time. Our next question is, what sorts of exchanges generally accompany marriages? Marriage is usually accompanied by bride service, bride wealth, or dowry exchanges. In bride service, grooms work for the family of the bride for an agreed upon period. In bride wealth, the family of the husband gives goods, livestock, and sometimes money to the family of the bride. In dowry, the family of the bride gives money and property to the family of the groom or the new couple. Our next question, what are the differences between nuclear and extended families? How is each type of family structure related to economic factors? The nuclear family is organized around the tie between husband and wife and is found predominantly in industrial societies and foraging societies. It is adaptive, where geographical mobility is important. The extended family predominates among cultivators. It provides a larger number of works or workers than does the nuclear family. And it allows land holdings to be kept intact over generations. Repeated, what are the differences between nuclear and extended families? How is each type of family structure related to the economic factors? The nuclear family is organized around the tie between husband and wife and is found predominantly in industrial societies and foraging societies. It is adaptive, where geographical mobility is important. The extended family predominates among cultivators. It provides a larger number of workers than does the nuclear family, and it allows land holdings to be kept intact over generations. Our next question is, what are the three most common rules of residence and how do they differ? The most widespread rule of residence is patrilocality, which requires a wife to live with her husband's family. Matrilocality, which requires the husband to live with wife's family, is found primarily in horticulture societies. Neolocality, in which the married couple lives independently, is particularly well adapted to industrialized societies where the mobility of labor is important. Our next question, how is the American family changing? American ideology often stresses the importance of the neo-local, independent, nuclear, and monogamous family. However, this form is challenged by the high divorce rate, increasing number of single parent, especially single mother families, and the increasing presence of women in the labor market. Repeated, how is the American family changing? American ideology often stresses the importance of the neo-local, independent, nuclear, monogamous family. However, this form is challenged by the high divorce rate, increasing number of single parent, especially single mother families, and the increasing presence of the women in the labor market. Our next question, what is the sum of the anthropological evidences that gender is culturally rather than biologically determined? Margaret Mead's early studies, as well as subsequent studies of variation in gender roles across cultures, support the prevailing view in anthropology today that gender is culturally constructed. Our next question, what is the difference between sex and gender? Sex refers to biological differences between male and female. Gender refers to social classification of masculine and feminine. Our next question. How does cross-cultural evidence raise questions about the Western view of division of humanity into male and female? How does cross-cultural evidence raise questions about the Western view of the division of humanity into male and female? Answer. Although all cultures distinguish between masculine and feminine, some cultures also include alternative in between or third gender roles. These include the two spirit role among Native Americans and the Hijra of India, that is transgenders. Our next question. What are Hijras or transgenders and how is their position in the Indian society different from sex or gender roles in US culture? Hijras are men who dress and act like women, are regarded as ritually powerful devotees of the goddess Bahuchara Mata and perform ritually at weddings and childbirths. Hijras are different than transsexuals in the United States. Hijras are members of an in-between gender. In United States, transsexuals are individuals born with one biological sex who have become members of the opposite sex. Our next question. Are sexual behavior and sexuality doing what comes naturally? Views about the nature of male and female sexuality are part of the gender ideologies. Sexuality and sexual behavior, though rooted in biology, are patterned by culture. Our next question. What are initiation rituals and how do they function in different societies? Initiation rituals are formal rites, R-I-T-E-S rites, that transform boys and girls into adult men and women. Both male and female initiations transmit cultural values and emphasize the importance of social membership. Male initiations also reinforce the solidarity of men, culturally validate male dominance, and may symbolically enable men to master the conflicts generated by boys' early identification with their mothers. In matrilineal societies, female initiations publicly emphasized the status change from child to adult, make statements about gender relations, and enhance a girl's attractiveness to men in preparation for marriage. Our next question. Is male dominance culturally universal? How do you explain male dominance in any particular society? Early work in feminist anthropology assumed universal male dominance. However, although patriarchy is common, more recent work shows that the position of women is extremely complex in the most societies. Some factors that affect women's positions in their frequent association with the domestic sphere rather than the public sphere, and the fact that men often more economic resources than women. Our next question is, are foraging societies gender equal? We are asking, are foraging societies gender equal? Men and women probably come closer to gender equality in foraging societies than in most others. In many cases, women make important or even a majority of contributions to food supplies. Among the Tlingit, T-L-I-N-G-I-T, Tlingit, a matrilineal society of the northwest coast of the North America, women were actively involved in the economic exchanges and had important positions in kinship and political networks. Our next question, how has the impact of the Western economy and culture influenced gender relations in different horticulture societies? Gender relations in horticulture societies vary considerably. Often the impact of Western economies has led to a decline in the economic status and prestige of women, as illustrated in the Nukumanu, N-U-K-U-M-A-N-U Nukumanu at all in the Pacific. Repeated, how has the impact of the Western economy and culture influenced gender relations in the different horticulture societies? Gender relations in horticulture societies vary considerably. Often the impact of the Western economies has led to a decline in the economic status and prestige of women, as illustrated in the Nukumanu et al. In the Pacific. Our next question is, what appears to be the effect of the rise of agriculture on gender relation? How do globalization and industrialization affect gender roles in different societies? In agricultural societies, women's roles tend to decrease, and the private or public dichotomy, D-I-C-H-O-T-O-M-E, dichotomy becomes more relevant. Development projects, particularly those involving the use of heavy technology such as tractors, sometimes marginalize women and reduce their autonomy and status. And as illustrated in anthropology, makes a difference section in on China. Even when women benefit by working in factories, they are also subject to severe restraints and difficult working conditions. Repeated, what appears to be the effect of the rise of agriculture on gender relations? How do globalization and industrialization affect gender roles in different societies? In agricultural societies, women's role tends to decrease, and the private or public dichotomy becomes more relevant. Development projects, particularly those involving the use of heavy technology such as tractors, sometimes marginalize women and reduce their autonomy and status. And as illustrated in the anthropology makes a difference sections on China, even when women benefit by working in factories, they are also subject to severe restraints and difficult working conditions. Our next question, what is the relationship between the pastoralism and gender hierarchy? In what ways are the Tuareg, T-U-A-R-E-G, Tuareg, an exception to most pastoralist societies in this regard? In pastoral societies, men gain dominance through their control over large herd animals. Male dominance is also supported by patrilineality, although the private or public dichotomy is weaker than the agricultural societies. The Tuareg, a matrilineal society of North America, are an exception, and women have substantial freedom, which, however, varies with the commitment to Islam and is both strengthened and weakened by male migration to cities for employment. Thank you very much.